In this video, we're going to talk about quoting in ShellScript. You will have used quoting in other programming languages. In C, you would have used double quotes for strings and single quotes for characters. In Python, it wouldn't have mattered whether or not you used single or double quotes. In ShellScript, there are three types of quoting. We've got single quotes, which are used for strong quoting. We've got double quotes, which are used for weak quoting. And we've got the type of quote you might not have seen before, back quotes. Which are used for command substitution. So, first up, we're going to have a look at single quotes, which are used for strong quoting. Let's print out something in single quotes using echo. Inside the single quotes, I'll put another echo. I'll put something that might look like a variable, some special shell characters. And when I hit enter on this, you'll see it just echoes back character for character. No attempts to run commands, interpret variables, or do anything with special characters. So that's what strong quoting does. Absolutely no interpretation at all. The only problem occurs when I want to actually print out a single quote. Usually I use backslash to escape the single quote, but special characters are not interpreted within single quotes. I must end the single quoted string. So if we're going to print out the cat's pajamas, I've got the cat, and now I want a single quote, an apostrophe, so I must end the single quoted string, print out an escaped single quote, start another single quoted string, and I've got S and pajamas in there. The cat's pajamas. Then we have weak quoting, or double quotes, which will interpret variables and also back quotes. So say I've put my name in a variable. Got my name is Helena. Cool. And I want to use this to print out a little message to myself. Echo hello name. And we got hello Helena. So within the double quotes, the variable gets interpreted and printed out. Now I could have done that exact same thing without the quotes at all and got the same result. So if I do hello name now. Same thing, hello Helena. The difference is, in the first case, this whole thing is treated as one argument to echo, one long string with spaces in it. But in the second case, we're giving echo two arguments, this word and then a variable to print out. We can see this more clearly if I put a bunch of spaces in between. If I do it with no quotation marks, the spaces aren't kept. But if I do it inside double quotes like this, the spaces are kept. Since double quotes limit what gets interpreted, they can also be used to print out some special shell characters. Say I want to print out a friendly smiley face along with my little message. So I'll do hello, name, and a smiley face. Cool, works perfectly. However, if I didn't use the double quotes, it would come up with an error. Let's quickly show you the error. Oh no, syntax error near unexpected token. And this is because the closing bracket is a special character in shell. We often use double quotes around variables if we suspect those variables may contain spaces that we want to preserve or special characters that might get interpreted. Back quotes are quite different from the other two types of quoting. They're used for command substitution. Anything with back quotes will be run as a command and the output captured. I have here the full text of The Hobbit in a file, and we can use word count wc-w and give it The Hobbit, and it will tell me how many words there are in The Hobbit. Say I want to store this output in a variable. I surround the command I'm interested in running with backquotes, and then what we'll call it numwords. I can set a variable equal to the output of that command. Beautiful. I can then print out my variable in a sentence using double quotes like before. So we'll say, the hobbit has numwords words. Numword rather than words. There we go. The hobbit has around 97,000 words in it. Or, since remember that double quotes will also interpret backquotes inside them, I can skip the variable altogether and just use backquotes to call that command inside the double quotes. So we have, what was it, wc/w, and give that the hobbit.txt. Exact same thing happens. As an example of where I might not use double quotes around variables, or where I might want to, let's say that I'm going to use egrep to find all occurrences of a certain phrase in both The Hobbit, which I have here, and Pride and Prejudice. The arguments I give to egrep are the phrase that I want to look for. In my case, it's going to be looking for places when people are called my good sir. And the files that I want to look in. So we've got Pride and Prejudice and The Hobbit. There's also a video on using egrep if you want to check that out. But what if instead of giving it an actual phrase, I want to give it a variable? Say search for this variable which holds a phrase in these few files. In that case, let's make a variable. So we'll call the variable search, and it's going to be my good sir still. And now when I call egrep, instead of giving it the phrase my good sir, I'm going to give it the variable, but I must surround the variable in double quotes. So there we go. Exactly the same thing happened. We got one instance of my good sir in Pride and Prejudice and one instance in The Hobbit. However, let's have a look at what happens if I don't put double quotes around there. And this is going to get a little bit messy. Oh no! So what we can see here, it is matching instances of just my. So because that variable had spaces in it, when I gave it to egrep without double quotes around it, it took those spaces to mean my as one argument, then good as one argument, and then sir as another argument. And egrep doesn't work this way. I have to give it one argument, one big string for it to search on. Say if I also wanted to use a variable to ask it to search, or a variable that holds which files I want it to search through. So we'll make that variable, it'll be books, and we can actually use our backquotes here. Books, it's going to be all of the files here that start with anything and with .txt. Cool. In this case, I don't want to surround that variable with double quotes. Let's put it in here and I can show you. So search surrounded by double quotes because it's going to have spaces in it. Books not surrounded by double quotes. And we'll see that works. Again, in this case, I do want it to interpret my variable as several different arguments. My first argument is the first book. Second argument is the second book. If I put double quotes around that books variable, it will complain that this file does not exist, that is prideandprejudice.txt space thehobbit.txt. That doesn't exist. So those are cases where I may or may not want to surround variables by double quotes. So hopefully now you have a bit more of an insight about quoting in shell.